Hi, year 5 and 6. It's me again, Mrs McKee, in my hot hut, ready for chair drumming lesson number 2. So, we're going to do a little bit more body percussion this time. We're going to vocalise the sounds of the drum kit today. We're going to try and see if we can finish off the rap section of the song we started last time, and then you're going to get to do your first session of chair drumming. So, I hope you found some space. I hope you've got your chair and your sticks ready. I want you to get stood up, and we'll do some counting. Okay, so last week we did counting to 4. This week we're going to do counting to 8. We're going to keep a steady pulse going from 1 to 8. I want you to choose 2 numbers between 1 and 8. Do that now. I've chosen 3 and 6 for my numbers. Now I want you to choose 1 vocal sound and 1 body percussion sound. So that could be tapping your head, your shoulders, your chest makes a good sound, a cuppy clap, a stamp, click, anything you like. So 1 vocal sound and 1 body percussion sound. I want you to put 1 of those sounds on your first count. So I'm going to use a cup on count 3. And then I want you to do your vocal sound on the other number. You can swap them around. You don't have to have your vocal sound second, you can have it first. So I'm going to go for a cup on 3 and a boing on 6. Have you done that? Try some sounds out now. What's going to work for you best? Okay, so the plan is we're going to keep walking all the way through this. We're going to internalize the beat of 8 counts. 1 and 1. Now, while you do that, I want you to go back to your 2 sounds that you thought of. You're going to see if you can insert them into the counts that we're doing. Obviously, I won't be able to hear them, and I'm going to be making my own sounds on my own counts. I hope you've chosen something different. If there's more than 1 of you doing this, maybe the 2 of you can choose a different count. Okay? So we're going to internalize the 1 to 8 with our feet, and you're going to put your sounds on the counts you've chosen. Are you ready? So mine is going to be cup on 3 and boing on 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Boing! Boing! Do it again. Boing! Well done, good. Did that sound interesting with me doing a completely different number? Try swapping them around now. I'm going to put my boing on 3 and my cup on 6. You can swap yours over too. If you want to, you can choose a completely different set of numbers and 2 totally different sounds if you like. Off we go, 1. So swap them over. Here we go. Boing! Boing! Last one. Boing! Great! Now let's go a bit faster. Ready? Steady. Off we go. Ready, steady, off we go. Boing! Boing! Great. I hope you didn't find that too difficult. You can practice that at home if you like. You can have more than two sounds going at the same time if you want. But as I said, it's really good fun if you have more than one person doing it too, and you fill in the gaps. It's all about keeping that pulse all the way through whatever sounds or actions you're making. That's part of the secret to being able to do chair drumming. Okay, so I also said that we were going to vocalise the sounds of the drum kit today. So let's make sure that you can see me and I can see you. Fantastic. Okay, so I don't know if you've ever looked at a drum kit really closely, but it's made up of quite a lot of different bits. And all those bits are playing independent parts all at the same time. So, as I said last week, the part of the kit you can hear all the way through is either called the bass drum or the kick drum. It has a little pedal and your foot keeps the pulse going all the way through. So that's called the kick drum. The next one that you might hear all the way through, that we kind of had a little bit of an explore last week using our pats on our knees, is called a snare drum. Like I said, that's that cracking sound quite often, or a real good tap that goes all the way through. That's usually played with the left hand. Even if left-handed drummers play, they usually will play the snare with their left hand. So that's this one here. Then you've got a set of two little cymbals that fit together that have another pedal attached to them so that they can come apart and close up together. And usually drummers will play those with two sticks together lent over on their left hand side. That's called a hi-hat. That makes a really, really sharp and usually fast sound going all the way through the music. So they're called a hi-hat. So far we've got a kick, a snare, the hi-hat, and then you'll see an array of different sizes of cylinder sort of drums, small ones, big ones that go on the floor. They're called the toms or the tom-toms. And as it suggests, whatever the size is makes a difference to the sound. So the small ones are going to make higher sounds and the big ones on the floor are going to make lower sounds. So we're going to try and copy the sound of a drum kit in this next exercise, and we're going to keep a pulse going all the way through as always. We're going to do the bass drum, the kick drum first. It's not exactly beatboxing today, but if you want to do your best beatboxing sound, go ahead, I really don't mind. But this is our pattern that we're going to learn today. Okay, so our kick drum is going to go like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, boom, 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 join it, boom, 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 boom. You get a really good buh sound, get your mouth moving. Okay, one more time, off we go, boom, 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 boom. So there's a rest at the end of that, great. All of these are going to be in patterns of four. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is the hi-hat sound. So that's those little cymbals on the side that you would use two sticks for. But we're going to make it a bit simple today. So I want you to go like this. Join in. Great, so really sharp sound right behind your teeth. That's the hi-hat sound. Next one we're going to do is the tom sound. Okay, and this needs to be quite low in the voice with a good dum at the beginning of it. It's going to go like this. Off I go. Dum, 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 dum. You could choose higher and lower vocal sounds if you wanted to. Do you want to try it with me? So maybe make the first two high sounds and then the last one a low sound. Off we go. Dum, 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 you've ever heard the beginning of EastEnders, those are the drums that they're using for that first section. So, last thing we do is going to be the snare drum. You can play that with one hand, you can also play it with two. And this is going to go a little bit faster. I don't want to hear a really good ch sound on this one. It's going to go like this. Chaka 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 cha, chaka 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 cha, chaka chaka chaka, join in. Chaka 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 cha, chaka 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 cha, chaka 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 cha, chaka 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 cha. Okay, so we've got our four different sounds there. I'm going to play a bit of a backing track and let's see if we can do all four of them with our best beatboxy noises, if we've got them. If not, do your best. Okay, so here we go. Start with your bass drum. A bit slower than we did it. Goes like this. Boom, boom, boom. Hi-hat now. Now the tom. Doom, doom. Doom, doom, doom. Doom, doom, doom. Doom, doom, doom. Now the snare. How did that go? Did you manage to do all four different sounds? Fantastic. I want you now to choose which one you're going to do. You can just do the bass drum. You could just do the snare drum all the way through. You can swap them about. It's entirely up to you. Let's see if you can remember them. So it should work that I'm doing something different to you and we're doing them at the same time. That's the whole idea of the drum kit, is that we're doing independent parts at the same time. So choose one of them. Are you ready? You can do your bass drum. Doom, doom, doom. Or you can go tss, 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 tss on your hi-hat, or doom, doom, doom on your toms, or the chaka, 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 cha. I'm not going to tell you which order I'm going to do them. See if you can do it in a different order to me. Are you ready? Let's try it again. Here we go. We're going to start straight away this time. Did you make a completely different pattern to me? I really hope so. Fantastic! Okay, so we've done some vocalised beats, we've made the sound of the drum kit, we've got our bodies ready, we're internalising the pulse. As I said, right at the end, we will put those all together with our chair drums. But before that, it would be great if we could see if we can finish most of the sections in the We Will Rise song that we started last time. As I told you last time, there are some tricky, fast sections in this song. So I thought we'd start with a bit of a warm-up, a bit of a tongue twister. See if you can say this, first of all, with me. Kevin's curly whirlies. Kevin's curly whirlies. Kevin's curly whirlies. Kevin's curly whirlies. Now see if we can do them all the way through with a pulse, not stopping in between. So one. Kevin's curly whirlies, Kevin's curly whirlies, Kevin's curly whirlies, Kevin's curly whirlies. Excellent. See if you can go a bit faster. One, two, three, four. Kevin's curly whirlies, Kevin's curly whirlies, Kevin's curly whirlies, Kevin's Curly Whirlies. Really get your mouths moving. Fantastic. Now we're going to put them on a pitch. So we're going to sing those words. So it'll go like this. Kevin's Curly Whirlies. 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 Do it with me, go. Kevin's Curly Whirlies. 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 Did you do it? We can go a bit higher now. Off we go. Kevin's Curly Whirlies. 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 And now a little bit higher. Off we go. Kevin's Curly Whirlies. 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 One more pitch higher. And this time, tiny bit faster. You ready? Off we go. Kevin's Curly Whirlies. 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 One last time. Kevin's Curly Whirlies. 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 Excellent. I hope you're getting your lips nicely moving and your teeth ready to make some fab sounds in our We Will Rise song. I'd like to go all the way through from the beginning, see if you can remember the bits that we did last week. And then you also get to listen to the, it's not a rap because you're singing it, the vocalised sort of chanting sections after the choruses. Okay, so if I get the track ready. Hopefully your voices are nicely warmed up. Now we'll see if you can remember the bee bits. So sing along with all the bits that you remember. We've got four bars. We will rise inspired. Here we go.
We will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be. We will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be. And the load that you carry is just too much to bear. It takes every bit of you just to hold your nerve when you feel it screaming, but you're not getting hurt. Steady your breath and sing it out. Oh, we will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be. We will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be. And the grip of the night when there isn't any sound as your mind cuts loose and you're hungry for control. You might feel alone when you close your eyes, but we're all the same under our disguise. Steady your breath and sing it out. Oh, we will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be. We will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be.
If you remembered that from last time. Okay, so it's time to get our teeth in and try this little chanting section in the middle. Here I go. So, you ready? My go first and then it's your turn. There's a pain in your head and a grip in your chest. So it's all on one note. Off you go. There's a pain in your head and a grip in your chest. Try it again. Off you go. There's a pain in your head and a grip in your chest. Great. Now the next thing goes like this. And you don't know what to do for the best. Off you go. And you don't know what to do for the best. So those two together go like this. There's a pain in your head and a grip in your chest, and you don't know what to do for the best. Try it with me, off you go. There's a pain in your head and a grip in your chest, and you don't know what to do for the best. It's a bit of a mouthful, right? Third section goes like this. And the load that you carry is just too much to bear. So that goes down at the end. And the load that you carry is just too much to bear. You try it. And the load that you carry is just too much to bear. Okay, so three lines there. From the beginning, I'll do it first. Off I go. There's a pain in your head and a grip in your chest, and you don't know what to do for the best. And the load that you carry is just too much to bear. You should be able to do that all in one breath if you take a massive one right at the beginning. You ready? Huge breath. One, two, three, four. There's a pain in your head and a grip in your chest, and you don't know what to do for the best. And the load that you carry is just too much to bear. Did you get it? You'll get it the more we do it. Next section goes like this. Takes every bit of you just to hold your nerve. I'll do it again. Takes every bit of you just to hold your nerve. Your go, off you go. Takes every bit of you just to hold your nerve. And now this is a real mouthful, this last bit. When you feel like you're I can't even do it. When you feel like you're screaming and you're not getting heard. I'll do it again. When you feel like you're screaming but you're not getting heard. Your go, off you go. When you feel like you're screaming but you're not getting heard. So those two together, I could do with a drink actually. Here we go. Takes every bit of you just to hold your nerve when you feel like you're screaming but you're not getting heard. One, two, three, four. Takes every bit of you just to hold your nerve when you feel like you're screaming but you're not getting heard. And then the very last bit goes, steady your breath and sing it out. I'm sure you can do that bit. Steady your breath and sing it out. Great. So from the beginning of that section, take a big breath. Because there's not much space for you to take a breath in the middle, that's for sure. Okay, so I might go first and then it's up to you. So off I go. There's a pain in your head and a grip in your chest, and you don't know what to do for the best. And the load that you carry is just too much to bear. Takes every bit of you just to hold your nerve when you feel like you're screaming but you're not getting heard. Steady your breath and sing it out. Okay, you ready? One last time. Everybody together. Oh, one, two, three. Four. There's a pain in your head and a grip in your chest, and you don't know what to do for the best. And the load that you carry is just too much to bear. Big breath. Takes every bit of you just to hold your nerve when you feel like you're screaming but you're not getting hurt. Steady your breath and sing it out. And then we go back to the chorus. I really want to move on to our chair drumming in a minute, so how about we go back to the beginning, sing the chorus and that section, and then we'll come back to the rest of it next time. Here we go. I told you that there were lots of words in this. Blah, 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 blah. Here we go.
We will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be. We will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be. And you don't know what to do for the best. And the load that you carry is just too much to bear. Takes every bit of you just to hold your nerve, and you feel like you're screaming but you're not getting hurt. Steady your breath and sing it out. Oh, we will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be. We will rise inspired by all we have seen, all that we've done and all we can be.
And we'll come to that last bit next time. Well done. I hope you're really enjoying singing this. I think it's quite a meaningful song for the times we're in now. but it's a really good sing as well. I hope you're really enjoying it. Okay, so I'm going to need to move the camera now. I'm going to need to get my chair ready. Time for you to get your chair ready as well. To make sure that you can see the seat of my chair. I've put my towel on the back there. I've got my sticks. I hope you've got your chopsticks or your rolled up newspapers or your wooden spoons, whatever you're going to use. Doesn't really matter. And we're going to use all of the chair today. We're really going to just get used to holding the sticks and keeping the pulse with them. So, you've got two sticks. Obvious that. Now, once upon a time, drummers used to hold one stick in one way and one stick in another way. Sometimes drummers still do that. Mainly jazz drummers would use that particular hold. But really, all we need to do is to get used to holding them like this. So you want to get your hands about two thirds of the way up the stick, okay? So not right at the end, like this. Not halfway, because you won't have enough flexibility. It's about two thirds, okay? So the fat bit of your hand is almost right at the bottom, okay? And you don't want to be holding them too tightly, otherwise your wrists will get really, really tired. They need to be able to have a little bit of movement. Can you see they're a bit wobbly there? They're sort of, your little finger can sort of control how much they bounce. Okay, so not like this, not like this. All your fingers holding on, okay? So they're slightly flexible. And can you see how my wrists are moving? You want to get your wrists moving as well. If you do your whole arm, that's going to get really tiring, really exhausting, really, really quickly. So just have a little try. Maybe you can see better this way. Of just getting your wrists moving flexibly. Great. Okay, so you can see this. You can see this. I might actually use the sides of the drum as well today. We're going to do both sticks at the same time today, okay? And if you feel confident while we're doing this, you can get your foot to do that kick drum sound all the way through. It would be really good practice for later on. So that's keeping that pulse all the way through, okay? So most of the time I'm going to do eight taps, but I might just change and ask you to do four. Okay, so we're going to use this as the top. This is the seat. I might say sides. I might say legs. I might ask you to do it above your head. You probably can't see me, but I'm tapping my sticks above my head. I might ask you to do them to your sides. I might ask you to go all the way around. So that's like a sunrise or a rainbow, all the way over. And then to be really complicated, I might ask you to hold one stick like this and tap the other one like a cross shape all the way up the stick. So starting from the bottom, all the way up the stick. Okay? So I'm going to get a track going now. All you have to do is to keep that pulse going and do the actions that I ask you to. Okay. Are we ready? Let me see if I can get the right track going. You might recognise this one. So foot going all the way through if you can. If not, just concentrate on getting the hold of your sticks.
Okay. Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I had the sharpest tool in the shed.
Right, let's start on the back.
She was looking kind of dumb with her finger in her thumb
and
the shape of an L on her forehead.
Back to the back.
Well, the years start coming and the years start coming. Back
five,
to the
six,
rules
seven,
and I hit the ground running.
Seat.
It makes sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your
head
gets
dumb.
So much to do, so much to see, so much for our mistake in the back
street. And the legs.
So never know if you don't go. No matter shine if you don't go.
Back to the back.
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play.
Sight.
Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
Sight.
It's a cool
well
place.
Done, okay. Okay, so now we're going to go to the above your head actions. We start with our crossed sticks above our heads. And to your left. To your right. Everybody, that's really the basics of learning how to play the drum kit. This could be your hi-hat, this could be your snare, and this could be your kick drum, just your foot on the floor. So remember to bring them again next time. We'll go a little bit further next time I see you, but in the meantime, take care, have fun, stay safe. I'll see you soon. Bye.